Today we'll present the Nacelle Trainer, which is part of the Wind Turbine Training System, which is a new product family for LabVolt. Here is a demonstration of what you can see in the actual large wind turbine nacelle. You see all the main parts that a maintenance technician working in this field would see in his day-to-day work. First, you'll see the yaw system, which enables the nacelle to rotate to face the wind. After that, we add a hub which will get the wind energy in the main shaft and rotate here until it reaches the gearbox. The gearbox will increase the speed of the main shaft by about 40 times. Then, the output of the gearbox will be monitored with a speed sensor. After that, there is a disc brake like in real nacelles. When you want to do maintenance on the wind turbine, or you have an emergency situation where you need to stop the nacelle, you use a disc brake. Then, after the multi-disc coupling, you have the generator. So you have here the whole assembly of an actual large wind turbine nacelle. Also, we have included a custom hydraulic unit to control the brakes of the nacelle, one of which is located in the yaw system, and another in the high-speed side of the drivetrain to activate the turbine brake on the disc. After that, on the nacelle training system, you also have an electrical panel, which includes all the electronics and control components to control the whole nacelle. We also have a touchscreen industrial computer, which includes an HMI, or human-machine interface, and a software PLC which will command the whole system. Also included in the nacelle trainer are the weather sensors to monitor wind speed and direction. This is the section representing the yaw system. We have a gear motor that will drive the pinion using a slewing bearing. This is a standard slewing ring, like the kind you'd see in a real wind turbine, just a little bit smaller, but still large for a training system. You have the hydraulic hose that will go to the hydraulic brake that will stop the disc when the wind turbine is aligned with the wind. Down beneath, we also have a cable twist sensor that will detect if the nacelle has made too many turns and the power cables are twisted. We also have an optical encoder that will read the relative position of the yaw compared to the ground. So the wind simulation induced into the HMI by the student will create wind conditions that the nacelle will respond to. We will set the direction regarding the actual position of the nacelle, and will also set the speed of the anemometer. We have motors that drive those sensors, but we actually use the feedback from those sensors, so the simulation routine of the sensor and the actual reading are two separated processes in the PLC. So depending on the signal received from the weather sensor, the nacelle will decide if it has to realign itself to face the wind. This process is simulated in this whole area. The yaw motor would drive the slewing ring, which will make the tower turn to face the actual direction of the wind. Just above the yaw system, we have a gear motor that is used to simulate the effect of the wind facing the blades and to transmit power to the whole nacelle drivetrain. The gear motor, with a system of sprocket chains, will drive the main shaft and then transmit power to the gearbox. This is the main shaft section of the nacelle trainer. The power transmitted from the gear motor, which is below this drivetrain, is transmitted to the sprocket chains, and then the main shaft rotates at a maximum speed of 47 RPM, which is similar to a large wind turbine nacelle. This disc has two purposes. One is for speed detection. We will measure the speed of the low side speed of the nacelle. We also have a rotor lock device. This device is used to represent the actual hydraulic piston in the nacelle that will block the hub when a maintenance technician has to exit the nacelle, go on top, and then go in the hub to do maintenance. We don't want the hub to start to rotate with the technician inside. The main shaft is directly fitted in the gearbox to a coupling system which is located here. The main part of the nacelle, which is also the part that drives a lot of maintenance tasks, is the gearbox. The gearbox will increase the speed of the low speed side to the high speed side for about 40 times, so you have at the rotor main shaft a speed of 47 RPM and exit to the nominal speed of the generator, which is around 1800 RPM. The gearbox has a cutout view where you can see the actual movement of the gears inside. You can also see the oil running through those gears. This gearbox is an actual wind turbine gearbox of a 5 kilowatt turbine. When we exit the gearbox, the first thing we do is to measure the actual speed on the high speed side of the drivetrain with an inductive proximity switch. Then we have the main part between the gearbox and the generator, which is the disc brake. And then we have a double-acting hydraulic brake that will brake the disc and then brake the whole drivetrain in case of emergencies or maintenance to be performed by a technician. We also have a torsion-proof multi-disc coupling that joins the high-speed side of the gearbox to the generator. This is the same kind of coupling that is used in real wind turbines. We also have another disc which is used to create vibration in the drive shaft, and using this vibration sensor, you can monitor the actual vibration at different places in the drivetrain, and the PLC can decide whether or not to stop the application. As in an actual wind turbine, we also have a hydraulic unit, which is normally custom-made for each turbine. We have different kinds of hydraulic components, like valves, check valves, relief valves, and an accumulator for emergency braking in case we lose power in the nacelle. Each of these valves can also be manually activated for troubleshooting or activated through the PLC. We also have a hydraulic tank and filter. This hydraulic unit provides power and control to both brakes of the nacelle training system. We also have two hydraulic gauges that can be fitted using removable ports at different points of the hydraulic unit to monitor the pressure at those points. On a wind turbine, every hydraulic unit also has a hand pump that is used to increase the pressure in the hydraulic unit in case of power loss in the nacelle. To activate this hydraulic hand pump, you have to use this removable rub and fit it into the hand pump, and then increase the pressure into the system. The whole nacelle training system is controlled through a PLC, which resides in this industrial computer, which is also a touchscreen panel. This PLC is a Siemens PLC that will communicate through industrial networks like Profibus and Profinet to the components inside the electrical panel. You can see that the electrical panel has see-through glass so the students can view the components inside. You can also open the electrical panel. The PLC inside the industrial computer controls and monitors a set of remote aisles. In the electrical panel, you also see power supplies, 24 volts, 5 volts, a series of contactors for all the equipment in the system, breakers, fuses, a variable frequency drive for the yaw system, the drivetrain, and the hydraulic unit. The touchscreen interface is a human-machine interface to control the whole nacelle training system. In the main window, you see the different parameters of the nacelle, like the rotor, the RPM on the low speed or the high speed side, the gearbox temperature, the vibration in the system, what the yaw is doing, moving clockwise or counterclockwise, and the brake, applied or not. You also see the wind direction in the actual nacelle position against the wind, the blade pitch position target and the actual position, and since the hub is simulated, this section is also simulated, the hydraulic unit status, and if good connection is also established, which is also simulated. The student has to enter a wind simulation path. 10 steps are programmed into the application. The student can select if the step is enabled or not, set the duration in seconds, set the wind direction, or set the wind speed in meters per second. The trainer can also be switched to imperial units. So when the simulation is set, the student just has to start it and all these steps will be simulated in the weather sensors. So now we can start the nacelle in automatic mode, and the nacelle will monitor the data coming from the sensors and it will decide which action to take. A trend section is available in the HMI to display some important parameters in the nacelle, like the yaw position versus the wind direction, the generator speed versus the wind speed, the generator power, the rotor vibration, and the pitch blade versus the wind speed. An alarm section can also be used to troubleshoot the unit, where every possible problem will be sent through this alarm, and the user will be able to acknowledge and reset the alarms. A fault section is also available for teachers, where you have to enter a username and password, which are normally given by the teacher. Once the username and password have been entered, you can go to the fault insertion section, and you have a series of hardware faults, which are normally open contacts in the electrical panel, or simulated faults, like gearbox high temperature or bad oil quality in the gearbox. The teacher can set a delay to when this fault will happen in the system, and then press the on-off button to activate that fault, and it will take place in the delay set by the teacher. The nacelle trainer can also be put in manual mode. In manual mode, you can control the hydraulic unit, start it, stop it, set some valves on and off, and release the brakes. The user can also jog the rotor at a predefined speed and move the yaw as desired. Services windows are also accessible for the different parts of the nacelle, like the yaw service window, where you can see all the important parameters in the yaw operation. The yaw can even be calibrated from this section. If the user has one of the two hub trainers from LabVolt, the hub services window permits the user to connect one of them to the nacelle trainer, so the blade pitch command is actually performed on the hub trainer and the feedback is sent back to the nacelle. This is the end of this presentation.